Kristie J with Stitch in Heaven, and today we're going to make this beautiful wall hanging that is going to be super fast, super easy, and make an art piece in just an hour or less. And I'm going to show you how to do it. We have these kits, and the kits are all inclusive for you. So you've got the panel. We have a new product in here called Grab and Go. Use and Sew, and that is exclusive to Stitch in Heaven. It's got all your borders, it's got your binding, and it also has your backing. So we've included everything in here for you. All you have to do is add batting in your sewing machine, and you are ready to go, ready to sew. So let me kind of show you how this works. So you'll get a package like this. There's instructions on the back and everything you need. And we're actually going to open this baby. Kind of show you what the contents look like. I chose this panel because I thought it was absolutely beautiful, but I didn't want to use it just how it was. I wanted to make it more special than it was, and it is truly beautiful. So the panel is cut to size for the center, and it looks like this. It's an Allison glass fabric, and it's absolutely gorgeous. So you're going to have your panel. You're gonna have your backing, and the backing may vary, but it's absolutely beautiful and it coordinates. It's one of the coordinating fabrics from the Allison Glass line. We're gonna have binding. I've actually included a piece of fabric for you to cut your binding because some folks like to do a straight binding. Some people like to do a bias binding. I'm gonna show you how to do the curves later. If you do the curves, you're going to want to cut your bias binding to use. So that's why we gave you a chunk of fabric instead of cutting it for you. You've got these are your borders, and we will be using these. So I'm just going to lay these out. And then we have this beautiful piece here that we have cut and fused for you to use on top of the beautiful panel. And it's gonna go right on top. See how stunning that is just looking at it? So I'm gonna show you how to do this, okay? So first of all, what we're gonna do is just lay out our pieces. I'm gonna stick the binding piece and the backing to the side because we don't need those right now. And let's get started. So first of all, we're just gonna take our panel and we're gonna put the first borders on. So the borders that I selected, if you'll notice, is that gray border. So all you're gonna do is line them up and you're gonna do the two opposite sides. So the top and the bottom first. So let's get sewing. So we're gonna go to the machine. And we're gonna just do a quarter inch seam. Why do we do a quarter inch seam? Because it makes it consistent, they're not too thick, and it's just the traditional seam for quilters, okay? Okay, so I'm just gonna put this under the machine and do that quarter inch stitch. Borders, and the nice thing is these are pre-cut by our people here at Stitchin' Heaven. Quilters as well, which is pretty amazing. So we're going to do just the top and the bottom. So just a line that you can pin it if you would like. I'm not a pinner typically. Sometimes I am, but typically not.
So what we're going to do after we do the top and the bottom, we're just going to iron that. We're going to press it, take it to our pressing mat, and we're going to press it towards that border. Okay. Let's do the other end. Look at it. I'm just going to press this panel out. Okay. So we are ready to go with the other two angles. So we've got the top and we've got the bottom, and we're going to go on the other two sides. And again, these are pre-cut, so they should fit nicely. And you can kind of see we're going to do this side first. Take it to the machine, do your quarter inch again. And we're just going to keep going, and we're going to do the other end. So we're just going to line that up. A super easy, quick project, and if you do have arthritis, it's a nice one because your piece is already cut, which is good. Or if you need something quick, a lot of times the struggle with getting started with a project is sometimes the cutting part. Once you get cut, it's kind of all gravy. You should get the fabric cut. Once you're done, you'll go back to the pressing mat, and we're going to press these outward. But you see how that gray just kind of frames that panel? It just makes it really pretty and makes those colors really bold. So I will tell you the pieces are cut pretty good. My piecing is not always perfect, but that's okay. That's the fun of this. It's okay. It's going to work out anyway, regardless. And sometimes I get busy watching TV while I sew. I don't know if anybody else does that, but I love to watch TV when I sew. And I'll be trying to figure out what's going on the Love Boat, and my seam will go a little askew. Love Boat and Little House on the Prairie seem to be my favorite these days. Okay. So here we have this part, and then we're going to do a secondary border. And again, these are cut for us, which is nice, so we shouldn't have to cut. So we've got these secondary borders, so you just kind of lay them out, and you're going to do the short ends first. So put the short ends to the short ends. Actually, the shorter ones should just go straight across. And then we're going to just sew. And again, if you would like to pin, feel free to pin. I'm not typically a pinner. I will kind of guide it just a little bit and just make sure my raw edges are together. So we're going to sew
short end. And let's go this way. Again, just make sure your raw edges are lined up and you're not going to pin it. And then again, we're going to press those outward towards the border. So take it. To your ironing board. Press it really good. I usually press those seams just to kind of set those seams. And then we're going to flip it outwards. Nice and flat. They've got so many pretty panels these days, too. You can do the same thing. And if you see a panel that you would like for us to produce this way, we can definitely explore it. So just drop us a note below or send us an email. If you're not on our YouTube site, we have a Stitch in Heaven YouTube site, and we have all kinds of tutorials and products and just different things that are going on at Stitch in Heaven. We also do a show on Wednesday that is called Stitch in Heaven Live, where we kind of talk about what's going on here, because there is a lot going on every week. Pretty darn good, not perfect, but doesn't look too shabby. All right, so what we're going to do is we're going to take the long sides and we're going to put them on the long end. We are almost done with borders. I know this seems like a long time, but it finishes in a snap. So again, we're just going to put raw edges together, right sides together, quarter inch seam. There's all kinds of quarter inch feet, or you can actually just move your needle position over. I prefer the one with the guide because, again, I watch TV while I'm sewing, typically. Or maybe visiting with people, or listen to an audio book, something, and sometimes my mind gets a little distracted. We have this so far. How gorgeous is that? Pretty amazing, right? Okay, are you ready for the magic? All right, we call these grab and go, fuse and sew, and everything's pre-cut for you, but here's the magic. We have actually cut an overlay for you with fusible on the back, so we're actually gonna fuse this in the middle. So a few things about fusible.
You want to use an iron on medium heat and you will get some pressing tips into your kit.
And you probably want a press cloth on top, just in case. So what we're going to do is on the back, the way you pull this off is you kind of score it just a smidge. I just kind of take it and go like this and the paper actually scores. And then I'm just going to rip it off. Actually, the ripping off, this kind of makes you feel good. Take out a little aggression on this thing. But all you do is just rip off that paper off the back. And you throw it in the floor. You have to pick it up later, so don't, you know, forget about that. But otherwise, we're just getting all that white paper off the back. because we're exposing the fusible and just getting it ready to fuse on. Fusible is nice because it's going to stick in place. We do recommend that you quilt it pretty densely just so it all stays where it needs to be. And when you're ironing, you just have to make sure you're on top of it. Okay. So placement wise, what we're going to do is you're going to kind of center it and use your lines. Okay. So put it exactly where you want it. And normally I'll just put my pressing mat underneath, which I'm gonna kind of go up under here. If you haven't used one of these wool mats, it's super nice. And it also, the heat kind of generates through it and back up, which is a nice thing about wool. So you're just going to put it where you need it, and then you're going to press the iron on it. Now that you have this in place, what you want to do is
you want your iron on medium heat, and you will get some pressing tips on pressing fusible in your kit.
Another tip is to use something to go over the top, so just in case the fusible gets loose, you don't want it on your iron. You can use a piece of scrap fabric for this, a piece of muslin, or there are these sheets that you can use as well. So you can just lay that on top, and you want to just press it really well and really hard. Move it around. You want to hold it from 6 to 8 seconds in place. And just make sure everything's down really well. And it will just take a minute, but once you're done, you got the beauty behind me and you're ready to quilt. This is also a great project for those people that actually are really into the quilting and the piecing may not be quite their thing. And there you go. It's your beautiful wall hanging. It is a grab and go, fuse and sew. It is ready to quilt just that quick. So you can do from here, you can do a straight binding if you want and do the straight border. If you want to do the curvy border, I'm gonna show you how to do that as well. So we will be right back with that.